start to know that how to write down the chemical reaction. Polyatomic ion. Polyatomic ions are those ions, it's a group of ion which behave like a single unit. These ions are called as polyatomic ion. For example, there is this ion which is OH. It's a group of two atoms. One is oxygen and one is hydrogen. So such a group like CO3, SO3, such kind of compound will behave like a group and have valency, they are called as polyatomic ion. They can be anions. They all are anions. Like on your screen there is ammonia, then hydroxide is the another group which is a polyatomic ion. Polyatomic ion, once again I say, is a group of ion which behave like a single entity and has a proper valency. Right now, today we are going to discuss about that, how to write down the chemical reactions. How to write down the chemical formula. There are certain rules for writing the chemical formula. When we are writing the formula of an ionic compound, that is the compound which is formed by the combination of anions and cation. The formula which is formed by the anions and cations, how we have to write down their formula. For there are certain rules and regulations which has been laid down by IUPAC. The first rule is that, for example, we have to write down the formula of hydrogen sulfide. I have to write down the formula of hydrogen sulfide like this. First of all, I will write down the name hydrogen sulfide. Okay. Then what to do? Then the first rule is that I have to write down the symbol for the elements which are mentioned in the name. I have to write down the symbol for those elements which are mentioned in the name, we have to write down about that. Okay, hydrogen and sulfide is there. That means the symbol. So we will write down like this, the symbol. There are two elements involved. One is hydrogen and one is sulfur. So what I will write down, I will mention their symbol. You know, the symbol of hydrogen is H, whereas the symbol of sulfur is S. Okay, so first thing which we have to mention is, right, while writing the formula, first rule is that write down the symbol. In case of a simple molecular compound, which is a binary compound, first of all we have to write down the symbol. Then second thing is that we have to write down the valency of the elements or ions below the symbol. Here the two elements which are involved is hydrogen and sulfur, and their valency. Now I will write down their valency. This is point number second which you have to keep into consideration, that first you are going to mention about the symbol, then second you are going to mention about their valency. As you know that the valency of hydrogen is 1. Valency of hydrogen is 1 and valency of sulfur is 2. Right? Now, once we write down the valency, the third thing which we need to do is criss-cross the valencies. crisscross the valencies means that write down the valency while writing the formula, we will write down the valency of the opposite one. For example, with hydrogen, I am going to write down the valency of sulfur, and with sulfur, I am going to write down the valency of hydrogen. This is the third step which we need to do. That is crisscross or crossover the valency of the combining atoms. And then we must write it like this. H2S. So formula will be H2S. This is the formula. H2S. In the same manner, if I have to write down the formula of magnesium chloride. Let us write down the formula of magnesium chloride. Now, how to write down the formula of magnesium chloride? First, I am going to write down the name magnesium chloride. Then I am going to find out that what all are the, I am going to write down the symbol involved in the chemical compound is magnesium. The symbol of magnesium is Mg. Symbol of magnesium is Mg, and that of chlorine is Cl. Right? That of chlorine is Cl. Now, second step is that I am going to write down the valency. Valency of magnesium is 1, and valency of magnesium is 2, and valency of chlorine is 1. Now, I will crisscross the valency, and while writing the chemical formula, I will write down Mg. 1 need not to be mentioned, because if we have mentioned the symbol, it already means it is one atom. So MgCl2. This is how can we write down the valency. This is how can we write down the chemical formula of a molecular compound. Then while writing the chemical formula of ionic compounds, we have to, in the ionic compound, this was all about it. In the ionic compounds, you can mention their positive or negative charges. Like just now I told you about magnesium chloride. Even if you will mention their valencies in +2 or -1, that way also we can write down the chemical formula of the ionic compound. Like I have to form the formula, I have to write down the formula of aluminium oxide. If I have to write down the formula of aluminium oxide, let me tell you, it's an ionic compound because this is metal and this is non-metal. So first I will write down the symbol. Aluminium symbol is Al, whereas oxide means oxygen. The symbol is O. Now, second step which I will tend to do is I will write down the valency. The valency of aluminium is 3 plus 3, and the valency of oxygen is -2. Now, crisscross the valency. But once we crisscross the valency in the chemical formula, we are not going to mention about the about these charges. Why? Because once they form the formula, once they exchange the electrons, at that time they will again become the neutral, because plus will be nullified by minus. So it will be Al2O3. This is how we can write down the formula. Now, if there is a polyatomic ion, how to write down the formula of the polyatomic ions, where the ions are involved, but they are the polyatomic ion. Same rule apply, except that the formula of polyatomic ion is written in brackets. While writing the formula of the polyatomic ion, everything will be the same, but only one thing is there, that the polyatomic ion will always be written in the brackets, right? And then we will mention about the valencies, right? For example, I have to write down the formula of potassium nitrate. Now, I have to mention about, I have to write down the formula of potassium nitrate. Again, let me tell you, there are two parts are there. So I will write down the symbol first. Potassium, the symbol of potassium is K, whereas the symbol of nitrate is 3, right? What then, second step, I will mention their valency, right? I will mention plus 1 minus 1, then crisscross the valency and write the polyatomic ion in the brackets, KNO3, like this, or you can also mention it like this, KNO3. Only up to that time if the valency of both of them is 1. For example, if I have to write down the formula of sodium sulfate, sodium is a simple element where sulfate is a polyatomic ion. I have to write down the formula of sodium sulfate, where sodium is an element and sulfate is a polyatomic ion. What I am going to write down first is the symbol. What I am going to write down the first is the symbol. Sodium symbol is Na, whereas sulfate is SO4. It's a polyatomic ion. Okay. Then second step, I need to write down about their valencies. I need to mention about the valency. Okay. Sodium valency is, or even you can say the charge. Right. Valency you can say, or charge you can say. At sodium is +1. Sodium is +1. And then sulfate, the valency or the charge which is present on the SO4 is -2. Right? Now I need to, for writing the chemical formula, I need to crisscross the valency and write it like this. Na2. Keep the polyatomic ion in the bracket Na2SO4. But we always need to keep the polyatomic ion in the bracket. Like there on your screen, there is the formula of calcium hydroxide. The symbol is calcium Ca. The symbol is Ca and the symbol of hydroxide is OH. Symbol of calcium is Ca and symbol of hydroxide is OH. Now, second step will be to write down their valency. Symbol of, valency of calcium is 2, whereas the valency of OH is 1. Let me once again write it down for you. For example, if I am writing about calcium hydroxide, right?
CaOH.
And now, first of all, I am going to mention about their symbol. It's Ca and then OH. Sorry, pens are not working properly. I don't know. OH, CaOH. Then, second step is that I have to mention about their symbols. First is I have to mention about the symbol. Second step is to write down their valency. Now, valency of calcium is 2, whereas the valency of hydroxide is 1. Third step is that crisscross the valency, Ca, and put the polyatomic ion in the brackets and then write down the valency. It will be like this. Right? Okay. Just now, write down the formula of aluminium phosphate in the table. Let me tell you, NCERT table number 3.6. You need to learn it. You need to learn the table number 3.6, where all the valencies are written. You need to learn it by heart.